Tribal marks and tattooing in Africa dates back thousands of years. It holds a fixed place in Africa's history. It is believed that the use of tribal marks on the continent increased during the period of the Atlantic slave trade.
Usually, you use tribal marks for purposes of identification of a particular ethnic or tribal or community that you are coming from.
Due to extinction of many smaller tribes in the society all over the world, so they mark you so that your tribe doesn't get extinct.
Nigeria is a country steeped in culture. In some areas, especially the north and western Nigeria, some people still mark their children, and for them, it is far from a trend.
Then my children, I mark some. I never mark some because of those days religion come bring us out, make we not tear our children.
Initially, I felt so bad about it, and I told my mom, when I grow up, I'm going to sue my dad's room. But later, you know, as time goes on with friends, this thing is very beautiful, and I see people trying to get it on their own. So I develop an interest, and I like it. I think if I have a daughter, I think she should have something like that.
In the olden days, when a child is born, the proud father allows his child to be given tribal marks as a way of expressing that he is the legitimate father.
It's my father that gave me to identify me.
I have what we call Bile and Fesungoshi. Normally it's from Katsina State, actually, where my father hailed from. But then also the Fasungoshi is something that also the Kanuri used to have. That's the Babur and Kanuri. And I have some part of me that actually came from the Kanuri part. I guess that's the Kanuri part. And here the Bidle, it's from my ancestry in Katsina State.
Ooh, I like my own. Any babe will see me, will say that man will have mark. I like it, so I like my mark.
Fulani women have faint tattoos or marks around their mouth. That signifies a rite of passage from childhood to adulthood. The Yorubas of Western Nigeria are best known for tribal marks.
In olden days, there used to be wars from one locality to the others. And the purpose of that tribal mark is to identify people for a certain locality or a group of people or a group of family. That's the purpose of the tribal mark in the western part of Nigeria. It has been given to me, so I don't feel anything. It makes me look handsome.
Unlike the House of Fulani and Yoruba, tribal marks are not common among the Igbos of eastern Nigeria.
Some Igbo tribes do have tribal marks, but it's not a common feature. Take for example, where I come from, Ohafia. If you're a visitor and you're arriving into my community way back, without the way of identifying you as a visitor is that you get a white chalk. White chalk will be, painted on your face, on your wrist, to show that you've arrived to the community and you are free and you are safe to move around.
These modern times, women go a long way to achieve flawless skin. What do people, especially the youth, feel about tribal marks?
I don't like it. It's so annoying. Makes one look very ugly. I don't like it. No. I'll just go for a face surgery. That's all. I don't take that. And I'll blame my parents for giving me a tribal mark.
Naturally, I don't like seeing it both in ladies or even in guys. I don't like it at all because I feel it's something that makes the face not look just beautiful at all.
In recent times, reasons for tribal marks are no longer valid. Our tradition is evolving. Therefore, some practices are expiring. In all the ways the Western world influences us, these trends should be subscribed to out of choice.